Hey, Pioneers, welcome to our newest edition of See You in the Workplace, where we're visiting notable alumni at their places of work, talking about their time at Carroll and how they ended up at their careers of today. I'm Zachary Stasheski with the Alumni Engagement Office, and this month I had the opportunity to speak with alumni couple Paul Vastag, class of 1990, VP of Business Intelligence at Continental Properties, and Dr. Karen Wagner, also class of 1990, a primary care pediatrician with Children's Wisconsin, to talk about their workplaces, as well as how they expanded their skills and perspectives through a Carroll-affiliated service trip to Africa in June of 2019.
What did you study at Carroll, or what brought you to Waukesha?
So when I went to Carroll, I was going to study international business. I took one business class and realized that was not my calling, which is kind of ironic now. And I lead our market research team that uses data to really find the best opportunities for commercial real estate investments. Just had a thing for geography, had taken the Geography 101 class with Doc Richeson, learned about geographic information systems and remote sensing, and realized, hey, this could actually turn into something.
So I studied biology. I knew since I was about 12 years old that I wanted to be a pediatrician.
Okay.
And so I knew I wanted to go to medical school. Always loved working with kids. I always, you know, was the one in the family who was playing with all the babies. Because, you know, Carroll's so small, you're directly working with the professors every day. So being a very small place, those relationships, the people that you meet have really stayed with me.
What was the first position you had after Carroll, and how did it lead you to your current role here?
So I had a great opportunity out in Redlands, California. They were a big player in the geographic information systems software. We were actually creating the first digital map of the world for the Defense Mapping Agency from their paper map products. And in doing that with the software, I learned a lot about database structures, building databases, did some programming. And even though it was very specific in terms of GIS, the parallels are there with what I do now in the real estate, commercial real estate world, which is building and using and analyzing data to make good decisions.
I did my internship and residency at Children's Hospital. I started working for them right out of residency, and I've been there ever since. I really realized, okay, that I want to do primary care.
Sure.
I want to be part of people's lives. I want to be able to help them.
Here in your workplaces, you build communities, you keep communities safe, and you were able to do that somewhere else because of a Carroll connection.
My first job out of grad school was with a company in Waukesha, and
back in the old stomping grounds?
Back in Waukesha, yeah, and it happened that Dr. Block, Dave, and Carroll needed someone to help with the GIS class, and so I did some adjunct teaching, was able to work with him in a professional capacity. It's kind of when he started talking about the Rebay projects through Carroll.
And Rebay is the village in Kenya.
Rebay is the village in eastern Kenya in Kilifi County.
While in his role as adjunct professor in the 90s, Paul and Professor Emeritus Dr. David Block built a friendship. This connection led to Paul and Karen financially supporting Dr. Block's work in Kenya for the last 10 to 15 years. In June of 2019, Paul and Karen felt they were ready to witness and contribute to the projects in person, so they took the leap, bringing along their daughter, Erin.
Started in the late 80s when Alan and Tito Katama's uncle was a Fulbright scholar spending time at Carroll, and then Alan Katama ended up coming to Carroll in the 90s, and that program began to grow then and then has since blossomed. It's a partnership between Dave Block and Tito Katama that really make this work.
I've always had an interest or a thought in the back of my mind that I'd like to, you know, do some international, more service work. I think anytime you can get outside of your comfort zone, challenging yourself, it can only improve. You're gonna bring back more than what you give, for sure.
We've been supporting this effort and these projects for several years and really learned a lot about the partnership between both Carroll and the folks in Rebay, Kenya. So it's really neat to be involved in a project that has 20 plus years of history.
Can you maybe talk about the contrast between what you're used to in your workplace and what you experienced while visiting and volunteering in Africa?
The biggest difference is obviously the lack of resources. The rebate clinic is very small, run mostly by volunteers. They were very well trained, but they just didn't have the equipment.
How do you use your skill set in mapping geography to benefit the Africa work?
Even in Kenya, there just isn't good base map information. The goal was to have a training session to teach the community leaders, some teachers, how to do that. We were giving them a way to put Rebay on the map so the world would know about Rebay.
After sharing their experiences from Kenya, both Karen and Paul were able to reflect on how this trip not only changed their global perspectives, but made an even larger impact on each of them as they returned to their workplaces at Continental Properties and Children's Wisconsin.
It was really nice for me. I think it was after being in practice for 20 years, just going there and enjoying the relationship with the patients and the families. So coming back, it just kind of refreshed my practice, I guess, and thinking, okay, this is the heart of it. You know, people just want to be heard. They want to tell their story. They want to really feel that I'm there to help them, and what drew me to medicine in the first place. So
if you have an opportunity to do something in a volunteering service capacity in your community or elsewhere, that will only help you get out of your comfort zone professionally, which can really lead to benefits and to further development and growth.
But you have an opportunity now to share that and try to make, you know, your workplace is better with the skills that you're bringing back to the clinic and to the office here. Kudos to both of you. So,
thank you.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was a great opportunity.
Great.
Someone gifted you a goat.
Yes,
so the church in Makobeni, a small community within the broader village of Rebay, they gifted us a goat as a thanks.
Where is this goat now?
So we had the goat for dinner that night and for breakfast the next morning.
Oh, so this
as well.
Is not a pet goat.
This is not a pet
like
goat.
I honestly was thinking that like it came with like dog tags and you named it.
No,
but
no. So the goat.
It.
The goat was.
Got it.
Was dinner and breakfast the next morning as well.
Yes.
So. Ooh, leftover goat. Good to know.